As shown in a previous video, I've been playing around with my new pen stroke simulator tool since I rooted my Supernote. In the process, I learned a bit more about the way these are stored in the .note and .mark files. The idea is that you basically simulate strokes with one parameter difference, and you look into the binaries with a hex editor to see what changed. Without a simulator, it's difficult because there's just too much information stored by the device before your pen even touches the screen. What do we know about the Supernote's proprietary format, and what can we do with better knowledge? Good questions. First, let's review what is widely known. See, though pen stroke's data structure in the binary is to this date a well-guarded secret, developers in the community have taken full advantage of a known feature, the fact that the picture resulting from the strokes is encoded in the binaries for thumbnail display or export purposes. Extracting this picture is relatively easy, and there are plenty of repositories on GitHub or GitLab doing that, with further conversions to PDF or other formats. But since this picture is an output of the pen strokes, it is ephemeral. The Supernote continuously replaces it to reflect pen stroke changes. You may try, as this guy once did when he thought he cracked the code to edit the picture, but your changes are going to be overridden sooner or later. In other words, if you want to modify a .note or a .mark file, you have to manipulate the pen strokes, okay? So you got to know how these pen strokes are stored. Editing the image is not going to help. An example of editing the strokes is the digest function in Python, where the selection strokes are made invisible before returning the modified .mark file to the Supernote. Just take a look at the digest section of one of the previous videos if you haven't yet done so. Another example. Let's see how Python could address a wish by a Reddit user a few months ago. The user wanted a tool to make existing strokes thinner. At the time, I didn't think that would be feasible without Supernote publishing their format. Let me show you how you do this in Python. If you want to replicate, you'd have to download version 1.08, which is in the beta branch at the time of this recording. I'm also going to use keyword settings to implement this solution. Again, if you're not familiar with keyword settings, feel free to look at the long video on Python features. But in summary, it's a way to program or allocate attributes to a specific notebook by attaching a special keyword through the Supernote interface. It's elegant in the sense that you don't need to use a command line interface. But you do need to create a small JSON file. Let's first look at a notebook example. On page 1, I have two columns of strokes, one in dark gray and one column of black strokes. For each, I incremented the needle point size from 0.1 to 2. On the second page, I have a few sentences that I copied to page 3. Now let's look into the JSON file called strokes-example1.json. A reminder, for Python to interpret that JSON, you'd need to attach a keyword called ks-strokes-example1. Okay? So what do we have? It's a JSON, a text file with key and value pairs. The Python usage key is just informational. You can infer from it that this file purpose is to define conditions to alter specific strokes by changing specific properties and making a copy of the modified note in a certain folder. In this case, the strokes are modified only if they meet certain size, color, and page conditions, also included in a JSON format. In size, you list the needle point pen sizes that are affected or excluded from this program. A minus sign means that you specifically exclude a given size. A positive number indicates that the program is specific to that size. An empty list would mean that the program would apply to all needle point pen sizes. So in this example, the strokes with specific needle point pen size 0.5 and 0.4 are affected. It also says that size 1 is specifically unaffected, though this would not have been necessary here. It's just to illustrate, okay? Likewise, the JSON says that it doesn't apply to strokes of color dark gray, and it specifically excludes page number 2. Now, what I need to do is to use the keyword setting ks-strokes-example1 anywhere in this notebook, okay? It's showtime. You can see that the destination folder was created and has a new output. This is a beta version. In the final, we'll push back the file to the Supernote. So let me manually move this file back to my Supernote. Let me rename it with mod to keep the original. Okay, I open the file and things look the same. Why? Because the Supernote isn't aware that we made a change. It did not have to redraw the static image. So let me try to select the strokes and watch what happens. The mere selection changed the colors for those strokes meeting the condition defined in the JSON. What about the size? This is also new for me, and I found that some more actions are needed to make a full refresh. Page 2 remains the same because it was specifically excluded and selecting and refreshing. Page 3 brings the expected alteration after selecting, moving, and refreshing. All right, please let me know what application you think is possible. Python runs Python on an external computer, but in theory, one could already build some smaller and faster app on the device itself. In the meantime, happy writing, folks.